Welcome back to Aviation This Week. Today's edition is brought to you by Lavero Aviation, your aviation solutions provider. Your top story, Virgin Galactic reaches space for the first time, then Transport Canada introduces new flight and duty time limits, and the Carlyle Group moves to acquire StandardAero. We'll have all your aviation news right after this quick message from our sponsor. For the first time ever, Virgin Galactic reached space as its spaceship 2, called VSS Unity, hit a maximum altitude of 82.7 kilometers during a test flight over the Mojave Desert. Unity was first carried by White Knight 2 to an altitude of around 15,000 meters, at which point the space liner was dropped before firing its hybrid rocket motor for 60 seconds. The rocket burn accelerated Unity to a maximum velocity of Mach 2.9. This was the fourth rocket-powered test mission of VSS Unity, which Virgin Galactic unveiled in February 2016. Virgin Galactic's primary goal is to have Unity carry passengers into suborbital space for around $250,000, allowing them to experience a few minutes of weightlessness and to see the curvature of the Earth against space. The aircraft will also be used as research vehicles. The latest test involved four NASA-sponsored research payloads. Mark Garneau, Minister of Transport, on December 12th announced major changes to Canadian aviation regulations, aiming to improve air safety for passengers and flight crews. The agency based its argument for the new flight and duty time limits, as well as new fatigue risk management systems, on the development of fatigue science and international standards. An example of the change from the old 1996 regulations includes flight time moving from 1,200 hours over a year to 1,000 hours. Required rest periods increased from 8 hours minimum, now up to as much as 12 hours. Canada's major airline operators have 2 years to implement the new regulations. Smaller and regional operators have 4 years to comply. The Carlyle Group on December 18th announced an agreement to acquire StandardAero, one of the world's largest MRO service providers for the aerospace and defense industries, from Veritas Capital. The transaction is expected to close by the end of the first quarter 2019. Financial terms were not disclosed, but Reuters has since reported the deal to be worth $5 billion US, including debt. This would be the second round of ownership under Carlyle, which first acquired StandardAero in 2004 and sold it to Dubai Aerospace Enterprise in 2007. Veritas acquired StandardAero 3 years ago for $2.1 billion US. This is Annex Business Media's Niche TV. Thanks again to our sponsor, Lavero Aviation, your aviation solutions provider.